Welcome to Jonathan's Cold-Blooded Critters. Today we will be exploring Disney's Animal Kingdom. Starting our day off, we will be taking a ride on the Kilimanjaro Safari. This has always been one of my favorite activities to do at Disney, and it really makes you feel like you're on an actual safari ride. They do a fantastic job of this because the majority of animals are free roaming and can even come right up to the vehicle. The only downside to this ride is that you're continuously moving and can't sit there observing the animals you want to see, so the majority of the time you only get a few seconds with each of them. But on the bright side, this is an amazing opportunity to see lots of animals from a unique experience. Make sure to comment which animal is your favorite, even if it wasn't on the safari. One thing that most amusement parks have in common so they have really long waits and the rides don't last long enough. But the safari takes about 20 minutes to complete, which is exceptionally long and well worth the wait. The duration is due to the large open land that they provide for these amazing animals, which of course is nothing compared to living in the wild, but as far as zoos go, this is a huge amount of space for the animals to explore. This is definitely a must-see if you are visiting Central Florida and love animals. And of course, it's just one of the amazing things about Animal Kingdom. They also have lots of other rides, shows, and well-decorated areas like the Land of Pandora from Avatar. It is hard to believe Avatar came out nearly 15 years ago, and I've still never seen it. Even with that being said though, Disney did a fantastic job making the Land of Pandora, and it's worth checking out. And as far as rides go, Animal Kingdom has the tallest ride that Disney has to offer at nearly 200 feet. I just always avoid this ride because I'm terrified of heights, but if you're interested, check out Disney's Mount Everest. But even with everything that Animal Kingdom has to offer, the safari ride will always be my favorite. There's lots of amazing animals to see. I just wish that one time I could see the lions because they're always sleeping. The only other animal I wasn't able to see was the hyenas, which I heard rumors that they were sent to another zoo for breeding purposes, but I couldn't find any evidence to support this online. Which is crazy to think that they've already transferred them because they just recently got them a couple years ago. But it is for a good cause, as breeding programs help repopulate animal groups in a safe and controlled way. As the safari ride comes to an end, it drops you off at the entrance to Gorilla Falls, which we will explore next. Gorilla Falls is a quick walking trail where you get to see lots of animals up close, like okapi, hippos, reptiles, birds, and of course, gorillas. One of the first animals is a newly born okapi named Elijah, with his mother Zelda, which we will see next. Elijah gets his name in a very cool way, by honoring a cast member who has worked for Disney for over 50 years. Following that, we venture into a building with smaller exhibits featuring many species of reptiles, but most of them were hiding, so we didn't get a good video. But we were able to see a large colony of naked mole rats, along with some pancake tortoises and a giant African bullfrog. Every time I see naked mole rats, it always makes me think of Ron and Rufus from Kim Possible. Let me know if you like that show too. I thought I would also mention that Animal Kingdom has something called Rafiki Landing, which has a petting zoo, lots of reptiles, and you can even take an art class to sketch some of your favorite characters. Continuing on, we found some hippos who were giving this bird a nice platform to rest on. And I personally think the one on the right was playing peekaboo with me, because every time I'd go up, he'd go down and vice versa. As we come to the end of the trail, we stumbled across this gorilla family who were playing tag with each other. Every time I stumble across a gorilla, it always makes me think of Harambe. May he rest in peace. But that's a topic for another day, because that's it for today's video. If you enjoyed it, make sure to leave a like and subscribe for more videos in the future.